time we're at Dorchester, which is 3 miles from Wallingford and 8 miles from Oxford. I did ask the woman bus driver if she knew just how far Dorchester was from the bus stop. She said she had no idea, but it might be as much as 2 miles. Well, we'll see. It certainly wasn't 2 miles. It wasn't even a quarter of a mile. Dorchester lies over an old Romano-British walled town, and this became the centre of the Saxon settlement. In 635, Dorchester was actually the centre of Wessex. People occupied Hill Fort, which is on Castle Hill. Later Celtic people built Dyke Hills, a rare example of pre-Roman town. Dorchester was built near the River Thames, which is also known as the Isis. It was inhabited since the Neolithic. There was a Neolithic site, but was destroyed in later years by the gravel pits. Coming up is the road most people are familiar with, because when driving through Dorchester, this would be the main route. On the Dyke Hills, the Romans built a settlement with a linking road to Alchester, a military camp. There were once 10 coaching inns, but only 2 remain now, the George and the White Hart. The George has a yard dating back to 1495. Okay, let's get across this road and have a closer look. Dead opposite the George is St. Peter and St. Paul, but everyone now refers to it simply as the Dorchester Abbey. Henry VIII dissolved the Catholic Abbey, leaving this small village with a huge Church of England parish church. Right next to the abbey is the museum, which is well worth looking at. Staff are very friendly and very helpful. looking at all the images in the museum gives you a real sense of history for the whole area. Visited Dorchester, it's well worth the effort. So much to see from various ages in history. As you can see, I did a lot of filming in and around the Abbey. Okay, here we go. Let's have a look inside now. There's a 14th century bishop effigy. As well as a knight, which is just referred to as the Dorchester Knight. This part of the building is called the People's Chapel. In it you'll find a 14th century wall painting. Also in the building can be found the 12th century Norman lead font. Even the stone floor needs a little bit of attention. A lot of the details have been lost in time, but still fascinating. Some nice footage of a night. There's also a medieval brass of a knight on the floor. Okay, time to leave here. We'll have another look around outside. Here is the Catholic Church. I do remember there was some sort of a Roman dig at some allotment. Exactly where, I don't know, but this looks sort of promising, so hopefully I'm in the right area. Maybe we'll find something, maybe we won't. Doesn't look very promising, does it? Not a sign of anything. Oh well, keep looking. And just when I thought I was actually wasting my time, here's a nice little sign for me to ogle at. Well, at least there's this sign. There's nothing else to actually see, but I found the area. Must be an excuse now to have a sit down, have a couple of sausage rolls and a cup of coffee. Haven't done too bad today. Still a little bit of time to look around the area, see what else we can actually look at before we actually think about getting back to Oxford. Wish I was eating a big plate full of and a topping of tomato sauce. Right, directly behind me was where they had their Roman dig. So it's all under this grass area now. Right, time to get up and move again. Aha, I can hear sheep in the distance. Distance, you can just about make out one of the area's landmarks, which is the Whittenham Clumps. Here we are, back to the main road once again. This is the Dorchester Bridge we're just coming up to. As you can see, when you're actually there's just nothing else out there. Miles and miles of just country, basically. So, head back. Well, my day here is gradually coming to an end, but it's been a most enjoyable experience. And if you've never been here, I suggest you rectify that. It's just a beautiful. You're going back in time almost with the, you know, just looking at the buildings, etc. Check it out. Oh, well, that looks interesting across the road. We'll check this little alley area out and see where we end up. Should be heading towards the main road. Try and find the bus stop, get back to Oxford. By the sound of it, we're very close to the main road. Good, this footbridge will get us on the right side of the road. I enjoyed my day out at Dorchester. I hope you had some sort of idea of what the area was actually like. Well worth a visit. Anyway, back to Oxford.